In this video, I am going to show you some strategies in combining workflows. This will be the final video in this series. We will put pieces of workflows to create a new workflow. This strategy is helpful when you are building complicated workflows. You can start building your automation workflows by creating specific ones that you can combine later. Let's use this workflow as our starting point. This was created when we learned about flow decisions. If you recall, once the user entered bill, it will give us this message, "Hello bill." Otherwise, it will display, "You're not bill." Now let's try to incorporate a calculator workflow in the current workflow. We will run the calculator once the user entered bill. There are two possible ways of attaching one workflow to another. The first one is using Invoke Workflow function in UiPath. The second one is by saving a workflow as a template. What's the difference between the two? When using the Invoke Workflow activity, the changes you will make in the Invoke Workflow will be reflected in the current combined automation. Saving the workflow as a template helps you preserve the original workflow file, so whatever modification you made in the template, no changes will be made in the original workflow. We often use templates when creating small pieces of common automation that are reusable and applicable in multiple workflows. So you can use templates if the workflow does not change over time. Most common example is when you create your own reusable snippets using data tables, and XML files. When creating complex UI automation, it is recommended to break it into smaller pieces that can be tested separately and then integrate them later in a bigger workflow. In our sample workflow, we should choose the first option, Invoke Workflow. Let's add an Invoke Workflow activity in our current workflow. Let's double-click to open it. Now we can append this field to the path of the workflow file we want to add. To make it simple, we can just click the ellipsis button to manually find it. That's it! Let's go back to the main workflow. To make it interesting, let's add some text in the message box. Do you still remember how to concatenate a phrase? We can use a plus sign and add a phrase in quotation. Notice that there's a space between the first code and the first letter of the phrase? You're right, it will add a space between the name entered by the user and the phrase. Let's go back to main and add an arrow in the true condition next to the message box. We just combined two different workflows. Let's save it. Now we have an all new workflow. Let's run it. First, let's put in the wrong name, Bob. It gives us this message box which ends the workflow. We'll run it again. This time, let's use the correct name, which is Bill. It gives us this message with the name entered and a phrase we added. Then, it triggers the calculator workflow which is running through an Invoke Workflow activity. Let's put in the numbers to calculate. It completes the operation and gives us the results in the message box. Easy, isn't it? What if we want to use a template instead? I'm glad you asked. Let's first open the calculator workflow. By going to the Start menu, the Recent Workflows, we will see a list of recent workflows you have been working on. Let's click the calculator workflow. It opens a new tab. In this Design tab, click the down arrow under Save. Let's click Save as Template. This will be saved in a template folder. Let's give it a name. Let's say Calculator. As you can see in Activities panel, a new template section has appeared. Let's open it. There is our calculator template. Let's go back to the main workflow we're working on. Let's replace the Invoke Workflow activity with a calculator template. Let's delete the Invoke Workflow first, then drag the template into the workflow. Let's open the calculator template. As you can see, these are the same exact contents of the calculator workflow, so nothing has been changed. Whatever changes we will do in the original calculator workflow, it will not be reflected here. Let's go back to main. Let's see how it goes. Let's now run the workflow. It works good as well. You can now save these combined workflows as a new workflow. This video gives you an idea on how to work with complicated workflows by creating simple, clear, and understandable components of automation and combining them to achieve complete and versatile workflows. Thank you again for watching. Till then.